We are now ready to find the most likely hidden pass in an HMM, and it corresponds to the following decoding problems that ask us to find the optimal hidden pass. The input is an emitted string and an HMM defined by four objects: alphabet, the set of states, the matrix of transition probabilities, and the matrix of emission probabilities. And the output is a hidden pass pi that maximizes the probability of x and pi. Probability of x pi, as we saw, equal to the product of probability of x given pi multiplied by probability of pi, and it is a product of n term, each term being the product of emission probability and transition probability, as described at the slide. To solve the decoding problem, we will try to build a Manhattan graph in such a way that every pass in this graph will correspond to a hidden pass in the HMM, and vice versa, every hidden pass in the HMM will correspond to a pass in the built Manhattan. For the coin flipping HMM with this HMM diagram, we will construct Manhattan consisting of two rows and n columns, where n is the number of emitted symbols. In this case, we will also add source and sink node to the beginning and to the end of the resulting directed acyclic graph. And for the HMM that emitted the string of symbols F, B, 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 F, F, we will construct the following pass through the Manhattan right here. And you see that for every string of emitted symbols, we can construct the pass in the corresponding Manhattan. For a little bit more complex HMM consisting of three states, our Manhattan will be built of three rows and n columns. Generally, if we have an HMM with k states, there will be k rows in this Manhattan. As before, we will add start and end states. And note that in difference from the Lyman Manhattan, when we had just three directions from every node, in the decoding Manhattan, we had many directions. Anything that goes to the east works in this newly built Manhattan. We now need to define the weights of edges in the newly built Manhattan graph for an HMM. Let's consider an edge that starts in column I minus 1 in state L and connects it to the node corresponding to state K in the column I. We will refer to this edge as L K I minus 1. Now, this edge corresponds to transitioning from state L to state K with probability transition LK. And it also corresponds to emitting the symbol XI from the state K. And therefore, we define the weight of this edge as weight LKI minus pi, and it equal to the product of emission probability emitting symbol xi from state k multiplied by transition probability from state L to state k. Let's see how would we assign edge weight for the crooked casino. In this case, as before, weight of the edge lki minus 1 equal to the product of the corresponding emission and transition probability. What about this edge? So the weight of this bolt edge from state B to state B equal to emission probability of emitting symbol H from state B multiplied by transition probability of moving from B to B, which is 0.75 multiplied by 0.9. And we will continue further with assigning probability of all edges in a similar fashion. And afterwards, we will construct a graph in which product weight of a hidden pass will be simply equal to the product of weights of individual edges, as shown on this slide. For example, the product weight of this pass will be simply equal to probability of XP. Therefore, we constructed a graph in which product weight of every pass equal to probability of X pi, exactly what we are interested in, and therefore the computing of probability of X pi and finding hidden pass pi corresponding to maximizing probability X pi is simply finding a pass with maximum product weight.